Sadashiro and welcome to Sada Learning Hub. In this video, I'm going to discuss about how to delete operation on many-to-one relationship. How to perform the delete operation on many-to-one relationship. Now, if we delete a child object, then Hibernate tries to delete associated parent also in many-to-one. For example, if you want to delete a child object, Hibernate itself try to delete the parent object in one to many. If the parent has some other child's objects, then the exception is thrown. If the parent has no more child's, then parent object is also deleted. See, for example, if one parent have a multiple child's, if you want to delete a one child, Hibernate tries to delete the parent also. While deleting the parent, while trying to delete the parent, if Hibernate is going to check, is there any other childs are available or not for that particular parent. If it is available, it throws an exception. If it is not available, simply it is going to delete that particular child. Right? If we want to delete only child by without affecting the parent, then we need to put cascade is equal to none. For example, if you want to delete the only child, if you don't want to delete the parent, in that case, we need to put a cascade type is equal to none. Otherwise, please leave it, don't put it cascade attribute. If you don't put the cascade attribute, simply it is going to take a none value. If you want to put the value, just put the none. If you don't want to put any values, just neglect the cascade attribute. By default, it takes the none value. Now, if you want to delete the parent, if you want to delete the child object, then automatically Hibernate tries to delete the parent also. Before deleting the parent, Hibernate checks if is there any childs are available in that particular object or not, parent. If it is available, simply it is throws the exception. If it is not available, any childs regarding that particular parent, Hibernate try successfully delete that particular parent also. If you want to delete only child, we need to make one attribute, cascade attribute. We need to put the cascade attribute as a none. Then Hibernate deletes only the child. It doesn't deletes the parent. For this, I'm going to explain a simple example on this. See, I'm going to create a simple example, many to one application. In this many to one application, I'm going to create a two tables. First, the two tables in the database. The first one is the vendor table. Vendor is the parent table. And one more table I'm going to create, that is called customer table. That is the child table. Now, in the vendor table, vendor ID is the primary key. In the customer table, VENID is the foreign key. Now, I'm going to put the relation between the two tables by using the vendor ID. Now, I'm establishing the relation between the two tables with the column vendor ID. Now, see here, coming to the inside of this project, now I'm going to create the resource files. Inside the resource files, I'm going to put hibernate.cfz.xml. Now, in this file, I'm holding connection properties and Hibernate properties and as well as the mapping resource files. Next, coming to customer.hbm.xml, this is the Hibernate mapping file. It is going to map your customer table with a customer POJO class. Next, coming to the vendor.hbm.xml, this is also mapping file. It is going to map your vendor POJO class with the vendor table. Next, coming to C, I am going to create three Java classes to test my application. The first one is a customer.java. A customer.java is a child POJO class. Now, coming to vendor.java, it is a vendor.java. Java is a parent POJO class. Now I'm going to test my application. I'm creating one simple client application called many to one delete parent client. I'm going to test my application by using this file. Now I'm going to explain two scenarios. The first one is annotation XML based configuration and as well as annotation based configuration. Now if you see, first I'm going to explain XML based on configuration. Please guys, if you want this project, just check my video description. See, in this pom.xml I'm going to put my dependencies, whatever the dependencies required to my project, I'm going to put all the dependencies inside my pom.xml. Next, coming to hibernate.cfg.xml, it contains the connection properties and hibernate properties and as well as the mapping resource files. Next, move to the vendor.hbm.xml. In the vendor.hbm.xml, I'm going to open my Pojo class also. I will put side by side. It will easy to understand. See, in this vendor.hbm.xml, there is a two properties are there. Now I'm going to configure those two properties into my mapping file. The first one is a vendor ID. It is a primary key column. And the second one is vendor name. This is the non-primary key column. In the Pojo class, remaining all are setters and getters and their constructors. Next, coming to the customer.java and coming to the customer.hbm file, mapping file. If you see here in this, I'm going to configure. Now there is a three properties are available. For these three properties, first one is a primary key column and the next two are the non-primary key columns. Now, if you want to, in the many to one, we need to map each, we need to map parent object into each and every child object. For that, what I'm going to do, I'm creating a parent reference in my child Pojo class. This is my parent reference. Now I'm going to map this parent property into my mapping file by using many to one tag. If you see here, this is my many to one tag. My customer class is going to establish the relation with vendor class. And coming to here I'm giving the property name is called vendor. That's why I'm giving the name is equal to vendor. And coming here, this is my foreign key in the customer table. Foreign key in the customer table and cascade is equal to all and coming to here lazy is equal to false. Now if you see, whenever you are doing the operation on the child, it will automatically reflects into the parent. For example, if you put the all, it is first record is deleted from the parent, child. After that, is it try to delete a record from the parent. Now if the parent is related with the multiple records, now then that time it will give you the exception. In that case, if here we need to put the none, whenever you are putting the none at here, it will deletes only the child record. I will show you. I'm putting the none at here. Right, I'm putting the none at here. Whenever you are deleting the child record, it is only deletes from the, it only deletes from the child table. It doesn't delete the corresponding parent. Why? Because here I'm putting the none. Means whatever the operations are we are doing in the child, it will only reflects on the child. It doesn't reflects on the parent. I will show you in the two scenarios. If you are putting the all, what it happens. If you are putting the none, what it will happens. Now I'm creating one simple client application that is called many to one delete parent client. See, this is my many to one detailed parent. In this, first I'm try to read my configuration file hibernate.cfg.xml. After that, I'm going to create my session factory bean object. This is my session factory bean object by calling the build session factory. Now I'm try to open my session object. After opening the session object, first I'm going to load the child by calling the get method. See here, get method, by calling the get method, I'm loading the child. After that, within the transaction, I'm going to delete my child object by calling the delete method. Delete method, what it does? Delete method is going to delete a record from the child table, whatever you are given. Now I'm giving the 501 record. I'm trying to delete it from the child table by calling the delete method. Now here in this time, what will happen? If you see in my customer.hbm file, in the customer.hbm file, I make it cascade is equal to none. If you are putting the cascade is equal to none, means it will only reflect in the child, it doesn't reflect in the parent. Means now I will show you, is it really works or not. Means it will delete only the child record, it doesn't delete the parent record. Before that, I'm going to show you what are the records are available in the customer and the vendor. See, select star from vendor and select star from customer. See, these are the records are available in the vendor table and the customer table. Now I try to remove the customer with the ID is 501. Now I'm trying to remove the 501 record from my customer table. Now I'm going to run this one Java application. Now see here, there is no cascade type is equal to none. Now coming here. Now I'm trying to remove this one. If you are removing this one, by default it takes none. If you are not putting anything cascade, by default it takes the none value. Don't worry. Run as Java application. See, the record is deleted from only the customer. It is not deleted from the parent. If you see data, now the 501 is record is deleted from the customer tables. Why? Because here I'm putting the none value. If you are not mentioned any cascade, by default it is going to take the none. Now if it is the none value, Hibernate does the whatever you are doing. The means here I'm doing the operation on the child, means it doesn't reflect on the parent table. For example, if you put the all. Now if I'm putting the all, I'm trying to delete the record is 502. Now I'm trying to delete the record from 502. Whenever it does the operation on the child table, immediately it will reflect into the parent table. Now see here, it giving the exception. Why? Because here the select operation is done, it is deleting from the customers. Now here what I'm doing, I'm trying to delete the record from the 502. Now I'm trying to delete the record from the 502. After deleting the 502, it will immediately reflects in the parent also. In the parent, whatever the 502 is record is there in the 502, see the 502 is related with the 111 vendor ID. Now it try to delete the 111 record from the vendor table. Now here we got the exception. Why? Because it is not able to delete the parent record. There is a one more record is available that is related with the 111. That's why it is not able to delete the record. If you see here, that's why it is not able to delete the record. That's why it is giving an exception. Now in that case, if you want to overcome this problem, just we need to put the none at here. If you put the none at here, it will delete the record only from child, it doesn't delete the record from the parent. If there is no relation between records, for example, if you see there is a 111 is there, in the 111 there is a two records are there. For example, if you don't have a two records, if there is a only one record, in that case we can put the cascade is equal to all. Whenever you're deleting the record from that here, automatically it deletes the record from here. Means it needs to one-to-one relationship, then only it is able to delete the record. here, but in this case, there is a many to one relationship is available. That's why it is not able to delete the record. In that case, we need to put cascade is equal to cascade type, cascade is equal to none value. Whenever you're putting the none value, it will reflect only the child table. It doesn't reflect the parent table. Now that time it doesn't gives any exception at here. That's why it is giving an exception. In this way, we need to configure the cascade is equal to some particular value based on our requirement. We need to put the cascade value by deleting the records, parent records or child records from database by using many to one relationship. Next, I'm going to discuss about how to configure, how to delete the record from many to one by using many to one in case of annotation based example. If you see in the annotation based example, I'm created a simple project called many to one application with annotations. Now see here in this pom.xml, I'm going to configure my dependency set here. These are my dependencies. Coming to mapping file, see these are all my connection properties, these are my Hibernate properties, and coming to here, these are all my mapping resources. Next, here there is no HBM files are there. Why? Because here I am going to use the annotation set here. Next, moving to the vendor.java. In the vendor.java, I am using the annotations. Now these are my properties. This is the this particular Pojo class acting as an entity class, and coming here, this is my table. I'm going to my Pojo class is mapped with vendor table database in the database. Now coming to this is my non-primary key, this is my primary key column, and this is my non-primary key column. Coming to the customer.java, this is the child table. In this table, this particular Pojo class acting as an entity class, and I am going to map this particular DB table with this particular Pojo class. Now this is my primary key column, this is my, these two are the non-primary key columns. Now here I am going to make @ many to one annotation. This is the annotation we are going to use to configure the many to one relationship. Now target entity means my customer class is going to establish the relation with vendor class. Now cascade is equal to cascade type dot all. Here also same scenario. If you are putting the none, it will be do only operation on the child table. If you are putting the all, it will do the operations child table and as well as the parent table. But if the more records are available in the parent child table, in that case, it will give you the exception. If it is only one record available in the parent and child table, it doesn't any issue. It's going to delete from the two tables. If you have more than one relation, more than one record are available for the child table, child records, in that case, it gives an exception. Now, if you see, there is a different methods are available. All is available, detach is available, merge is available, persist is available, and refresh and remove. These are the different methods are available to do the operation. Now, for example, I'm going to put merge. Now, persist, I'm going to try to put the persist. Now, fetch is equal to fetch data of dot eager means whenever you're putting the eager, it will loads the parent and child at a time. If you are putting lazy, it will loads only child records. @ join column means this is my foreign key column in the customer table. I'm going to map with the primary key column in the child table, parent table, sorry. That is about to configure the many to one annotation. Here the delete operation we need to give the importance to the cascade is equal to cascade attribute. Based on that cascade attribute only the records are removing from the database. Otherwise, if you are not putting properly cascade attribute value, it doesn't remove the records from the database, and also it will gives the sometimes it will gives the exceptions. Now coming to example delete dot delete parent. See here, in this I'm going to load my configuration file hibernate.cfz.xml. after that I'm going to create a session factory bean object by calling the build session factory. Inside build session factory I'm going to give a service registry class. Next, coming here, I'm going to create a session object by calling by open session method. Next, I'm going to load a customer, which customer you want to delete, by calling the get method. I'm trying to delete the 501 get 501 record. I'm trying to delete the 501 record. After that, I'm beginning the transaction. Within the transaction, I'm going to call the delete method. Delete method is going to delete the record from the database. Delete method is going to record from the database. Now I'm running this example and I will show you how it will work. See, the record is deleted from the customer. Now I'm not putting the alert here. If you put the alert here, it will throw an exception. But I'm not putting the alert here. Whenever I'm doing the operation on a particular parent or child table, I want to only do the operation on that particular table only. I no need to reflect on the parent table. That's why I'm putting the persistent here. If you are not putting the persistent here, it will throws an exception. For example, if I want to try to remove the 602 record. If I want to try to delete the 602 record, but here I'm putting the cascade is equal to cascade type dot all. I'm putting the all. In this time, it will throw an exception. For example, see here, select star from vendor and select star from customer. Now in the 601, 602, 603, there is a three records are available. When I'm trying to delete the record 601 along with the 222. Now here in this case, it will give you an exception. Why? Because the 222 is related with the 602 and 603 also. Now it will throw an exception. See, I will run and show you, is it really throws an exception or not. See, it is throwing an exception. Why? Because after removing the 601 record, it's tried to delete the 602 record. While trying to delete the 60 record, it is going to check, is there any records are depending on me or not. Now that there is a two records are depending upon the 222. That's why Hibernate itself is not able to delete the record, because of there is a two childs are available on that particular parent. That's why Hibernate throws an exception. See here, throws an exception called child record found. Child record found. In that case, here we need to put the persistent here. We need to put persistent here. Whenever you are putting the persist, it successfully delete the record. Just now I see, showed you while putting the persist. For example, I'm trying to delete the record 503. See, whenever I'm deleting the 503, there is a 111 is try to Hibernate try to delete the 111 also. But there is a 111, only one record is available, that record only I'm deleting. Now this case, there is no child record found. Now it is going to delete successfully. See, I'm going to delete, try to delete the record called 503. See, I'm trying to delete the 503. Here I'm putting cascade is equal to cascade type dot all. Now in this case, it Hibernate deletes the record from here and also it deletes from here. Why? Because there is no child records are available for related to 111. If there are any records, child records found, it will throw an exception. If there is no child records, it deletes the records from parent and child. See, delete from customer, delete from vendor. Now if you see the data, select star from customer, select star from vendor. Now 111 is deleted from the here and 111 is deleted from the here. Now if why 111 is deleted from the both parent and child? Why? Because there is a only one child is available for the 111 parent. That's why Hibernate able to delete the both places. If there is a multiple childs are available for the triple one, simply Hibernate throws an exception child found. Childs are found. This is the way to use the @many-to-one annotation. See, while deleting the records from the database in the many-to-one, we need to keep it in mind. We need to use the cascade attribute properly. If you are not using the cascade attribute properly, it will give you a bad result for you. Means inconsistent results. That is about to delete the records from the many-to-one. Next video, I'm going to discuss about one-to-many bidirectional. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, Sada Learning Hub. If you like this video, please click on like button. Thank you for watching.
Thank you so much watching this video. Hope this lesson helpful to you. Keep watching our lessons. Keep writing to us. Do not forget subscribe our channel Sada.Learning Hub, because we have many session that would help you to develop our skills, and I will be back soon. Till then, you take care. Bye bye.